It's been a long time, I know, since I've what do we call it? Hit the vlog machine here. Now I want to discuss. I'm going a little bit off into Jainism. I wanted to discuss Mahavira is his name. The veneration of Mahavira. It's a bit of a this book, and in its Jainism was the second religion after, or we call it religion, or philosophy, a philosophical spiritual place, after Hinduism, the creation of, a predecessor to Buddhism. So Jainism there, Mahavira was a great power of it. He was the one who found Nirvana, meditated for 12 years of his life in a wandering state, and found enlightenment. Now, when he died, there was a great cataclysm of occurrence, a great confusion that occurred. So there is this, what do we call it? We call this energy. We call this an energy that is created by one human, a walking human, a human being that endeavors in a spiritual place, creating actual consequence with the weather, with the world itself. You understand? It's having that type of energy of effect. So he has brought an effect. He brought an effect upon his death. All right. A great confusion. All right. So what his main, sorry, my lighting's terrible. My main, I want to go through right now. It states here, he did not, where is it? Having, he never is, oh gosh, I have to read it out to be fair. Okay. I have to read it out. Okay. All right. Having wisdom, Mahavira committed no sin himself. He meditated free from sin and desire. Now right there, meditating free from sin and desire. In our regular day-to-day state, as we're just walking around and we're thinking, that is a meditative state of your choosing. Any thoughts in your head are a meditative state. You do not have to be sitting in meditative pose. Now, when I say meditated through free of sins and desire, that is a major inclusion of all things great and wonderful, and a major exclusion of all things ugly and abhorrent and treacherous and evil. So, you know, you hear the news, whatever. That is an evil push of a sin. It's a sin because you become a propagator of it. You heard evil, you want to propagate again another evil. You become like a clone propagator. You heard the news ugly. You become a clone mimicker, a propagator of that event. All right, so here we have some terrible dastardly news, a person did this or somebody did that or whatever. And so you speak it out. You're repeating. You're not the sinner itself. However, you are repeating the terrible act or the terrible war or whatever. You're repeating it. Do you understand? So you can say, oh, there's a war going on, blah, 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 over there. You're a repeater. So what does that make you? In a way, it makes you a formative accomplice of increasing its duration of stay, doesn't it? It makes it a stronghold place. The weakener is the one that does not repeat it. The weakener of any war is the one who does not repeat it. You want to weaken war, you want to lessen wars on the world, you do not even discuss them. You want to increase wars? You talk about them. And I'm meaning here, in when I'm talking in a meditative state also, even in your own head. When we're looking at the Mahavira and his powers, you know, you're looking at Jesus Christ and his powers, you're looking at all of these great, great energies and their powers. What are they repeating in their head? If you're going to be repeating evils, if you're going to be repeating evils, then who are you but a sin propagator? Okay. Yikes. Ooh, I'm really in a little bit of a, what do we call that, a dominatrix spirit today. Watch out. We have, what a wonderful, okay, then here he says here, the great sage does not commit any wrong. Now, the great sage does not commit any wrong. So, now right then and there, here is Christianity just like, what? The great sage does not commit any wrong? Wrong is up to the Christians, I'll call them the Christians' interpretation, isn't it? And boy, do they have a list of wrong waiting for you. Christianity is a force that is built upon wrongs. That is the foundation of Christianity, are the wrongs. So here's this poor little devil, Mahavira. I'll call him a poor little devil to be funny, but yeah, we'll state the sentence again because it's amazing. The great sage does not commit any wrong. Now here, in this day and age, to take 12 years off and meditate, in so many of your eyes, is a wrong. You're a penalter to him. You're the one who will take that man, and you would scalp him for his action. There are so many mean people out there that do not allow that spirit to even exist. You prefer the industric state of Christianity? The industric state of work, work until you die? For any corporation, no matter what they do, or say, or think? Alrighty, so we're dealing with wrong, and the wrong colors. Okay, because that's such a beautiful sentence, you know, does not commit any wrong. And in that, as a major Jainist, of course not. He is not a cruel to animals. He does not eat the animals. He does not kill the animals. He is a quiet contemplative. He is not a disruptor. He is one who accepts abuse. If he is hidden, he does not yell. He just accepts abuse. He is a man, an innocent, an absolute innocent. So who are these aggressors? It's like the perpetual, we'll call it the perpetual, what was that group? Conquistadors. The Christianic conquistadors of corporatism all around me. Government itself is a conquistador. Your U.S. government, based upon Christianity, it may say that, oh no, we got rid of it, but in God we trust. We did not get rid of Christianity as the basis of this society. Christianity is based upon success. You succeed, you succeed, you succeed, you push, you work, you succeed more and more and more. It's about that interpretation of a human being acculated by money, by fanciful things, by an increased industry state. Government our governments on this planet are Christian pushers, all right? Christianity pushers. They are not pushers of this little sweet man who meditated for 12 years to find nirvana and who changed the world through his philosophies. They are not pushers of this man. So this is what we are surrounded with in many states of the human. Many states of the human that you come encountered with are disrupted by Christianity being their ruler, forcing them, flogging them into the work ethic. You know, in a world of, if we were a world of Jainists and Buddhists, we would be a world far, far less industrious, far, far less pollutive. Christianity is a dirty pollution to swallow, I'll say. It's a destruction to our planet. Since the advent of Christianity, we have destroyed the planet at a huge rate, because it's all about, I'm a good boy, I'm a good girl, I'm a bad boy, I'm a bad girl. Good in Christianity is to succeed. That means educationally, means going to school, to college. That means getting a good job. That means getting a better house. Do you understand? Do you understand the feed of Christianity? The feed of Christianity is another 100,000 houses built in China in a suburb. That's the feed of Christianity. It's like a giant monster that just keeps eating the planet. They'll even say, but what a beautiful change, isn't it, now that we have mountains constructed as cities? Well, let the asteroid come and get us then. Let the asteroid be attracted here and just take it away. What an ugly group. What an ugly group that prefers to damage its entire ecosystem for the state of its greed, where greed is accoladed as a good thing. Success, how successful are you? Are you working for the Catholics? Are you working for the Christians? Now, my grandmother, she was a very, very state Mormon, and in that particular Mormon that she preached was not about escalating out of her caste system at all. She was actually, most of her life was quite saint-like, aside from she had a few derogatories that she couldn't get rid of. But most of her life she stayed quite saint-like. Now, the ambition push drivers, the Catholic crunchies, I'll call you, needing your brand new car, well, you're definitely in exodus. You're in exodus from, because you're pushing the news, you're pushing that sin of evil again and again. You're propagators. Even think thoughters of evils. So Mahavira was a man who was a think-thoughter of non-evils. He pushed them away, you understand? He did not bring them into his thoughts or his thinking. Why? Why such a want for? Why does Christianity want it? That's what we have to ask. You know, why enter into such a... Look at this. Oh, I don't even want to talk about it right now. I can't believe it. I'm just happy I found him. I'm happy I found him in this little state of book. Yeah. Yeah, so it says here, he knew the thoughts of all sentient beings. So I know that's a little Dr. Doolittle, isn't it? So somebody will be like, oh, that's a wrong, you don't know that, blah, 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 blah. I'm like, well, wow. Just wow. For you to even say that. Because you're inflicting a wrong. You're one of those. You're a flogger. You're flogging the man for even knowing the thoughts of all sentient beings. Why do you want to be a flogger? Why do you want to be a conquistador? Why do you want to be the one who drags people through the streets and kills them intellectually, thought-think-wise, all because you are a Catholic? Oh, because you know what's right, and you know what's wrong. Is that what it is? Because you're a good girl? By stating that, you're a better person. Is that where you live? That must be what it is. It's all about the better person. You get your little chuffy moment. You get your little medal, don't you? Blink, blink to you. Well, there I am telling you that's wrong, but well. At some point, there has to be a comparison state here going on. You guys have escalated to a fact that's just... disgusting. Absolutely disgusting. We all know philosophers. They use the world philosophers of Eastern religions. We are not takers of the planet. We are not destroyers. We use the world lightly. We are not here to in this particular lifetime take as much resources as possible because it looks pretty. I know. I think back 2,500 years ago, you know, if that was it, if we were just a bunch of Buddhists straight off the bat, a bunch of Jainists straight off, what would the world look like? I would have giant redwoods right next to me. Do you understand? Right next to me. I would probably even be like touching one right here on my side. Do you understand? We would be a world free of pollution. We would be so amazing for all sentient beings. All plants, all animals. We would be so incredible. A boundless energy of rejuvenation and growth. Wow. The cycle of life, absolutely in continuance, without a death spiral. Because right now, Christianity has brought us into a death spiral. All right, Mahavira. I'm gonna have to read a little bit more of this dude, but wow. Where are the Mahaviras out there? I want each and every one of you to be a Mahavira. Don't you understand? That would be a beautiful world, a beautiful people. So let's stop propagating sin in our thoughts, in our discussions, and desires also. Because desires represent greeds and wants and accessibilities. I want, I need. You know, not even knowing the difference. Yeah, desires. Let's try to get rid of those also.